Hey everyone, I'm Pete, and this is the SparkFun Spectral Sensor AS7343. It's a pretty nifty new quick board that actually gives you 14 channels of spectral sensing across the spectrum. I'm gonna do a quick little demo here and we can see them in action on some bar graphs. All right, so I've got my red board plus. I'm just gonna do USB there and a quick cable to the AS7343. So the white LED on this is pretty bright. I'm gonna watch out for that once it turns on. We'll reset the board so it runs the code. Okay, and then on the web serial plotter here, SparkFun's fun new tool we just created for this product, all we have to do is hit connect, tell it the COM port we're on, and I'm gonna actually turn off auto ranging. So right now, the 14 channels of this sensor are streaming into this web serial plotter, and it's displaying the data in real time on nice bar graphs for us. So along the x-axis, you can see the different wavelengths that it's sensing. And then on the y, it's giving us a magnitude of the reading. So how much of that light in that spectrum band it's seeing. So let's go ahead and put something red in front of this. And we should see F6 go up a little bit. Let's see. There we go. Yeah, so clearly, the spectral signature of this box is very red. And now let's try something blue for fun. So you can see those climb up as I hold the sensor right on that. And I have one more other light source I'm gonna try. This is actually a UV. Whoa, yeah. So this is a UV flashlight. You can see that the bottom end of the wavelength of the spectrum there at 405 is just maxing out when we get that flashlight shining at it. So this is kind of a fun visual way to see exactly what the sensor is doing and see what it can actually sense. So on the bottom end, we've got the 405 nanometers. So we're getting down into the UV there. And then we've got 11 channels in the visible. So it kind of looks like a rainbow. It's all the light that we can see. And then it has a general visible channel, which is basically just how much visible light it can see. So that's the gray one over there. And if I cover everything up, we've still got a pretty bright light on this, so it's gonna see some, but you can kind of see that go up and down. And then it also has a near infrared channel, which is at 855. And so that's pretty neat too, to have 14 channels all in all on a single IC. And that's sort of what the beauty is of this AS7343 is. It also does flicker detection, which is actually that 14th channel. So that's why they call it 14 channels. Let's go ahead and try one other mode on this web serial plotter. Right now we're in bar graph mode. I'm gonna switch over to line graph mode, which is probably pretty familiar. This looks a lot like what you would see on the Arduino serial plotter. And it's gonna take the comma separated data and just plot it over time on a nice line graph there. So right now I'm getting a lot of visible and a little bit of red and yellow. And then if I bring this to the table, all those numbers are gonna go way up because that white LED is just blasting. And then if I take it away, you can see everything drop down again. So this is kind of nice to see change of what the values are doing over time. And then of course, there's also the terminal 1, 2, which basically just shows exactly what that comma separated text data looks like. You can also log that to a text file pretty easily by hitting the start log button. And then after you've got some data flowing in there, we're gonna hit save log, and it puts it right into my downloads folder right there as a CSV. So that's pretty sweet too. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop that. That white LED that is on the board is really bright. I'm gonna actually turn that off really quick because you can do that with an I2C command. And in the examples, we actually turn it on to provide light, and then you can measure the reflectance of a surface, but you can also turn it off to save battery and save your eyes while you're doing a demo. So let me just change this code really quick. And this one basically is the most simple way to use the sensor. It's gonna actually just give you red, blue, and green, and near infrared, if you're only interested in those channels. We kinda wanna start it simple. But what I was interested in is this LED on. I'm actually gonna comment that out and then run this code again really quick. So when this uploads, we should see this LED turn off, and then I can kinda hold it here and see some readings without it blasting me. There we go. So this LED is super efficient and very bright, as we just experienced. It's got a warm rating of 5700K, which is not very warm in terms of a light. Like, there's a rating for lights and it's just very white. It's almost like blue white. And we have the spectral graph for that LED in the hookup guide, so you can see what exactly it's outputting. And it's mostly visible, but it does have a pretty big spike down in the UV. So that's example one, and that's how to turn the LED off, which is also kind of useful. But then if you want to, you can just turn it on while you're doing your reading and then turn it off and save that battery in your system or whatever. It does have pretty impressive low power stuff, actually. So when you do put it to sleep, there's an example on how to put it fully to sleep. I was just measuring on my bench like 4 microamps, which is pretty impressive for not really pulling much when it's in deep sleep. And then there's some other numbers too for like when it's actually sensing. I think we were seeing about 370 microamps while it's reading. Still not a whole lot of power, so that's good. The LED itself is another story. When that thing is on, it's like 4 milliamps. That's a lot of power being used up. So there's the very simple basic example. There's the deep sleep example. It also does interrupts. So you can actually set a threshold on one of those channels and then it will fire a hardware interrupt pin if it gets above or below a threshold that you set. And you can also read that over I2C too. So if you don't want to wire up a actual hardware interrupt, you can just read the interrupt over I2C. Using a spectral sensor is pretty fun because you get to get a more detailed look at the light that's coming into your system, right? So the sensor is giving you all these little channels within the visible light. Some of our more simple light sensors would just tell you that there's light. You know, if you needed to know that there's light on and light off, that's a good way to get a amount of light. But this one's actually telling you how much of this wavelength within that visible light is going on. So you've got 11 channels there, pretty good granularity. And then also it can sense some near infrared and ultraviolet, like we did with this flashlight. So what do you do with that light? Essentially everything has a spectral signature. So when we looked at the red box, it was like pretty obvious that the red bar went really high, right? So that's in a very elementary form, like a signature of this box. And then same thing for the blue. But then when you're looking at any kind of surface, all of those bars are important and they all come together to form that spectral signature. And so that's an interesting way to do surface detection or object detection. It could be used in lots of different applications, like robotics. When you're looking for a red wall, you might be turning around and go, oh my gosh, I'm facing a red wall. I need to turn around or something. And if you're looking for a box, instead of doing a bunch of powerful image processing to actually look at all the pixels and see a box, you could maybe use this guy as a more elementary form of sensing that red box. And then, yeah, looking at lots of different light is always fun. You know, things reflect different amounts of light, so you can use the sensor to look at that spectral signature and detect what it is. The other use case we were talking about was potentially looking at plants. You know, the spectral signature of a healthy plant looks one way, and then when it needs more water and the plant has become more brown in the leaves or whatever, the spectral sensor can pick up on that and tell you that your plant life is unhealthy. So there's so many interesting applications in science with this, and yeah, the sky's the limit, really. Yeah, so if your next project involves spectral sensing, I'd highly recommend hitting up our website and checking out the AS7343 spectral sensor. That was pretty quick intro. Ooh, that is bright.